So when it comes to Tony Stark, in my opinion, there's no other better storyline for the character than the Invincible Iron Man story arc written by Matt Fraction. This 4-year, 10-year story tears down the character of Tony Stark and completely reforges him stronger than ever. I recently just read this and it's really good and highly underrated. And I think that's because of the 2008 Iron Man film. This comic book came out in 2008, during the time when the first Iron Man MCU movie was released. So people were more focused on this epic movie than on a comic book run. But in spite of all that, Matt Fraction's storyline kept going and it remained pretty strong. And what I liked about it is just the critical look at Tony Stark and his legacy. It's really a reckoning for the character. Deleting his own mind to protect his friends after the events of Civil War, Tony is taken back to his origins and goes through a walk of his history where he encounters visions of the weapons he's created and the lives he's destroyed. This journey brought Stark face to face with his deepest fears, giving him the courage to accept his past and outgrow his family's legacy as ironmongers. These are the kinds of stories that changes trajectory of character. With this particular story, it's like, in the past, Tony Stark, Iron Man, he's always been a tech genius without an equal. Now, Tony is forced to realize his limitations and what he can't endure. And part of that growth is trusting more in his allies. Pepper is given her own suit of armor, and together the two founded a new company called Resilient, dedicated to Tony's bright vision of the future. Reading this story, I realized how heavily the MCU borrowed elements from this storyline. I didn't know that because I never read it before. A perfect example of that would be Iron Man 3, especially with Iron Man 3. Tony lost almost everything in that movie, and he had to ask himself, is it the suit that makes the man, or the other way around? We see him at the end, he gets rid of the arc reactor. He gets rid of his past self. And going forward after that, he's a completely new character, accepting the past and taking responsibility and building a better future, trusting more in his allies, and really being that shining example of a better tomorrow. He's not Iron Man because he has to be. He's Iron Man because he chooses to be. That all happens within the Invincible Iron Man story arc. And honestly, I think there's a chance we could see Resilient in the MCU. Because think about it, after the events of Spider-Man No Way Home with the FBI shutting down Stark Industries, this would be the perfect opportunity to introduce the company Resilient, founded by Pepper Potts, in something like Armor Wars or Ironheart maybe. But I think the story is also good because it showcases the Mandarin pretty good. The Mandarin comes to destroy Tony Stark, basically, by assembling a cabal of Iron Man's deadliest enemies, kind of like an Injustice gang. This is one of the best stories with the Mandarin, and it's as much as his story as it is Iron Man's. The two are yin and yang, linked, and in this story, it's revealed that the Mandarin has been having his hand involved in every action Tony has made on his quest for a better tomorrow. This whole story is an epic death battle chess match between Tony Stark and the Mandarin. And we really get to see why he is just one of the most dangerous villains in comics. I really like this story a lot, and like I said, it's obviously been a big inspiration for the way they handled Tony Stark and Iron Man in the MCU. And now, after reading it, it makes me like and understand Iron Man 3 a whole lot more, especially the ending. When he talked about his journey coming to an end, he didn't mean that he was retiring or that he was done being Iron Man. What he meant was that now he's a changed man going forward into the future, facing new challenges and ready to face those things because he realized he makes the suit. It's not the suit that makes him.
You can take away my house, all my tricks and toys. One thing you can't take away? I am Iron Man.
Guys, you can read the entire 10-year run of Invincible Iron Man at readcomicsonline.com. I'll put a link below. My favorite issues are volumes 9 and 10, Demon and Long Way Down. I really like those two a lot because those two stories are kind of the midpoint of all this, where the Mandarin comes into play and Tony Stark is spiraling out of control with dealing with the stresses and the government putting pressure on him. It's a really good story. It's a very interesting story, and like I said, didn't realize how big of an impact it had on the character until I read it. It's like, while reading this, I'm like, this is almost his exact arc within the MCU. It's like they heavily borrowed elements from that storyline. And the Extremis storyline, where the Mandarin had the Extremis virus and was unleashing it out in the public, that's loosely what Iron Man 3 was based off of. So these Mandarin stories that feature Tony Stark going up against them, is like, even though unfortunately we never actually saw Tony Stark go up against the real Mandarin in the movies, the base of that has played throughout his entire story arc from Iron Man 1 all the way to Avengers Endgame. That's as good as it gets. Now, I would have loved to see him fight Wen Wu. I think just having Robert Downey Jr. and Tony Leung on the same screen, I think that would have been something epic and philosophical and action-packed. But I still think it was good. And like I said, it made me appreciate Iron Man 3 a whole hell of a lot more. But yeah, Invincible Iron Man, fantastic. 4-year story arc is really good, and I'll be sure to post a link where you can read it for free. Let me know what you guys think, though. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up, and if you're new here, be sure to subscribe. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.